A two-on-one with Guenzel. Here's Guenzel shooting. He scores!
Superstars have a way. And Sidney Crosby, who took a beating on the start of that shift, the Penguins turn the puck over as the Jackets are changing. They get caught 2-on-1. And look at this release. It's a perfect pass. Guenzel gives Crosby a target. And this puck is off the stick in the blink of an eye. Look at where it went. It went off the goalpost. Grazed it. A knuckler.
They want to get in on our forecheck and wear down our D. It's about executing for the Penguins.
Here's Guenzel scores off the end boards, and Jake Guenzel has tied it. Ron Hainsey took the shot, and Guenzel played the ricochet off the end boards and ties the game.
Well, for the Pittsburgh Penguins, a good job responding right off the faceoff, a faceoff victory, and then eventually getting that puck towards the net. And sometimes for a goaltender, very difficult to pick up pucks off the end boards. And Guenzel does a good job of finding that puck and putting it past Sergei Bobrovsky.
Boy, Guenzel's been hot. He scored in each of the last five regular season games, and now 7 goals in his last 8. Here's Daly to Guenzel. Power play goal in the series. Shot. And it went off Malkin. Why they score? Big shot, Guenzel. And Pittsburgh has its first lead of the night.
Well, you heard Tortorella talking about Dubinsky needing to not be so amped up in this hockey game. I think he was a little bit undisciplined on that penalty, and they're going to pay for it. The Pittsburgh Penguins get to work on the latter half of this power play. Guenzel throws this puck on net. It goes off of Harrington or Malkin right there, and eventually just juggles in. It's hard to tell. It goes off the end boards once again. I think it went off Malkin and then off the end boards right to Guenzel, and almost a carbon copy of his first goal. It goes right behind Bobrovsky, or it goes off the back of Bobrovsky. But a real weird bounce on the initial play by Guenzel, and nobody could really locate.
In behind the net, the Crosby line causing some problems here. Scores! Guenzel! Goal number 3 is the game winner in game 3. Jake Guenzel with the hat trick goal. And the Pittsburgh Penguins at 13-10 of overtime have taken a 3-0 stranglehold on the series.
Guenzel a shot. Guenzel a shot. Fought off by Bobrovsky. Another shot. They score. There was no signal by the referee initially, but they have scored, and it's Guenzel who has gotten it.
It's just been a 1980s game, Doc. It's been just amazing. That one went almost in off the stick of Malkin, keeping the play alive. Phil Guenzel, he's going to put it on goal. Shot blocked by Savard. Guenzel, one chance. Guenzel, 2 chances, and on the second one, he capitalizes. This Mighty Mike's been so good for the Penguins. Had a hat trick in the last game, and he's got one here again. And if you elevate the puck against Bobrovsky, you're going to have a lot more opportunity than if you shoot it along the ice.
And Ovechkin, and a shot is saved by Fleury. Rebound in front. Oh, and it wouldn't go. Big pile up in the goal crease. The referee is peering over the top of the net to see that everything is legal.
And Ian, Doc, I don't know how TJ Oshie didn't score on this. Oh, my goodness gracious. Kick save and a beauty by Guenzel.
And Oshie can't believe it.
The picture doesn't lie right there. Jake Guenzel, wow.
Down. Capitals make a move.
And it is a throw that time by Williams that does not work. And now a two-on-one developing. It's brought in by Guenzel. He's got rest with him. He scores! Jake Guenzel! And it's 3-1.
He can play defense too, 87 and white. What a job by Crosby and Guenzel.
The shot blocked by Sidney Crosby coming all the way back at the end of a long shift. Williams tries to shoot it from him, through him. The stick by Crosby. Here comes Guenzel. Left-handed shot coming down the right wing boards. You need a save from Braden Holtby. He doesn't give it to you. Defense to offense, 3-1 lead.
You think about it, I wonder how much he went to school on what Kessel did on the short side. Guenzel might have looked it off a little bit, but there was a lot of room on the short side there on Braden Holtby.
You got to get a stop there if you're there.
It is Ovechkin firing one, and that one deflected up high. Fed to the front and dug out by Cullen. Led back ahead, and Jake Guenzel ahead, and he has scored! Jake Guenzel with his seventh of the playoffs in his seventh Stanley Cup playoff game. And the score now is at 6-2.
Nice little backhand pass there from Matt Cullen, and Jake Guenzel puts it dead center.
Gone in the second period, brought back by Mata. Flung over for Guenzel. Guenzel sent one in front. Score off of Orlov! And it's 2-0.
Good fortune for Pittsburgh. Really bad luck for Dmitry Orlov. Jake Guenzel just putting that out in front, hoping for an opportunity or somebody coming off the bench. The only person it finds is Dmitry Orlov, and then the back of the net. But it all started in the neutral zone for Pittsburgh, winning one-on-one battles. Olli Maatta against Alexander Ovechkin moves the puck over, and then eventually Guenzel right off the skate Orlov.
Jake Guenzel with 8 goals. Away by Crosby, moves back in, 2-on-1 with Guenzel. Crosby to Guenzel, score!
You get the 4-on-4 hockey, a little bit more open ice, turnover in the neutral zone, and then Crosby over to Guenzel, off the stick and between the wickets of Braden Holtby.
Holtby had stopped 39.